KCCA law enforcement officers today conducted an operation against unauthorized food vendors in ungazetted places in the new taxi park. Some vendors use mobile charcoal stoves in crowded places in the taxi park, posing a danger to the public. This operation follows an outcry from the public operating in the taxi park. This prompted KCCA action to evict illegal vendors today. Some of the arrested vendors were seen aboard a KCCA truck with their merchandise. They were taken to the new park police post and later KCCA court. Haji Badru Serunjoji, the chairperson of the park, lauded KCCA for the operation. William Buyondo, one of the vendors, asked government to grant them licenses to legally operate within the park. The government, through the National Environment Management Authority, NEMA, will continue operations of evicting illegal settlers in wetlands across the country. While addressing journalists at the media center today in Kampala, the executive director of the National Environment Management Authority, Dr. Baibega Akankwasa, said the country has lost over 70% of the wetlands and the authority is doing restoration efforts. He added that about 214 settlers had been evicted in the Lubiji area and the remaining 100 will be evicted soon. Dr. Baidega confirmed that all illegal settlers in the wetlands were given a prior eviction notice in the year 2021, adding that no compensation shall be awarded to any of the evicted persons as it is stated in the law.
So you either go to jail for a maximum period of 12 years or pay a fine of up to 600 million as determined by court. Court can give you less. Court can give you, both. Court can decide to give you both.
He disputes the claim that some settlers have occupied the wetlands for over 20 years, saying that most of them settled there between 2012 and 2015. He further elaborated on the acceptable activities that are permitted in the wetlands.
Of course, some wetlands, like part of Namanve, were degazetted for industrial park in the past. That's a new process. It is the government that gazettes, and it is government that it gazettes. So if it was degazetted for industrial development, new process was done.
Baidega announced that the operation is soon going to areas of Golobi, Mutungo, and Chinawataka. The illegal settlers in these areas have been asked to relocate willfully. Today, the Green Schools competition continued the search for the best debaters on a regional level. They were in Busoga region to select the top three schools to compete on the national level. The event took place at Busoga College Muiri, where the schools that qualify will join their competitors from other regions in the final competitions in Kampala. In a display of confidence, students and their patrons arrived for the debate competition at Jinja College, appearing fearless for the upcoming challenge.
As the president of the debate club of Wanyange Girls, every assembly, we create a message to the entire school because we always hold our assemblies on Monday. And we encourage other clubs to at least every after 2 months to plant 5 trees per club. We have something more than 20 clubs in school. And we have also a school forest.
What can we do to stop the global warming? And for us to come up with this kind of debate, in our small way, I think we are making a big statement to the world.
Students knew that they were going to debate and they became more practical at school because there was no way they would debate about something you are not practicing. And it also helps them to come out with resilient and workable resolutions.
The manager of the Green Schools Initiative, who is also the editor of New Vision, highlighted the significant improvements demonstrated by the students, indicating that the initiative is moving in a positive direction.
The quality of debates has greatly improved. Students and the debaters are now more articulate and more knowledgeable about climate change issues. Also from the schools, the school patrons, they say the kids are now taking very keen interest and researching on climate change issues, which is really in line with the objective of this project of sensitizing the public on climate change issues, but using the school system as the vehicle.
10 schools qualified to compete for the top 3 positions in the Busoga region for the Green Schools competitions. These schools are aimed at becoming the ambassadors of the region in the national competition in Kampala, where the best debaters on climate change issues would be selected. Recognizing climate change as a critical problem both nationally and globally, Vision Group initiated this effort to engage the young generation in combating climate change.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.